Hey, I'm Joel Wanasek with URM Academy, and today we are going to unbox Red Miso by Animals as Leaders. And I am just so excited to have this band on Nail the Mix. First off, because it's not often we get to have a world-class instrumental trio on. Normally we have vocals and bands with vocals, so it's pretty cool to get to mix something like this. And second, I mean, this band is just iconic at this point, and they're just so incredibly gifted and talented, and I can't wait to break this down and for you to get a chance to sit down and mix this. So we have a dual Nail the Mix this month, meaning that we have two mixers. We've got Nick Morzov and we have Javier Reyes, who is going to mix, and I hope I got your names right, guys, but they're going to both mix this song together, which is pretty cool because normally we don't have somebody in the band that actually mixes the song. So that's really awesome and exciting. So I'm going to stop talking. Let's listen to this song, and then we're going to break this down and go through it and talk about some of the really cool things and some of the challenges that you're going to have when you mix this. All right, I think you've got a pretty good idea of what this track sounds like. So let's break down some of the hardest things that you're going to have to deal with when you're mixing this. So one of the major challenges, first off, is the extended range guitars. Because the guitars go solo, they're going to interject a lot of energy into the sub-bass region of the mix. And that's something that is always fun and challenging as a mixer to deal with. Let's hear some of this stuff. Check it out. So we've got some super low and deep guitars, which again is very, very challenging. So that's something you're going to probably have to spend a lot of time on. Another thing that I feel like a lot of people don't always consider is if you're mixing like a traditional metal song, right, where you might just have like one rhythm guitar tone the whole song, a bass and drums, you get that dialed in. I mean, that can take you a long time as a mixer to really get it to sound amazing. A song like this is super challenging and fun to mix because it has different tones at different parts of the song. All of them have to be treated almost like a separate mix, meaning that obviously you probably won't change your drum and bass tone too much, but meaning the guitars need to like wrap in and lock in with the rest of that mix in each section and all of the tones are changing. It really, really, really makes that exponentially more complicated to deal with because each section now has to have an amazing sound and they all have to work together in series. And that's pretty cool and very, very challenging. So I think that's something that a lot of people are going to struggle with and is going to be pretty cool. And I'm very, very excited about. There's some other cool challenges in this. We can talk about drums in a second, but I just want to mention now that the drumming is also very intricate and there's a lot of accent symbols and things like that. And that is something that I feel like can be very challenging because, you know, for example, if you have a overhead pair where, you know, if you have two mics, but you have a modern kit where it's, say, there's like 10 to 15 cymbals, there's a lot of those little teeny stacks and splashes and things like that that can get lost. And what ends up happening is, as a mixer, and you know, you mic and record everything on the production side, but when you're mixing it, there's a lot of challenge trying to get rid of some of the bleed where you don't want it, and getting those accent cymbals to come in and pop, but to sound good and to not just, you know, like destroy the drum mix and the balance. And it's very, very challenging, especially on something I think this intricate. So we'll take a look at the drums here in a second, but I just wanted to mention that because it is a challenge. There's a lot of cool guitar things happening in this song. We've got some cleans. Let's take a look at some of that stuff. We've got this cool effect thing. I love that. That's super rad. We've got some lead guitars here. We've got a couple of different microphones. Let's take a listen. They sound very similar, so he's done a very good job miking them. And they've printed all of the effects. So check this out. So that's always kind of nice and fun. Got some other cool guitar stacks. Take a look at these and see what kind of stuff they have. I like that tone. It's got a very cool glassy characteristic to it. The one thing that was interesting in the notes that they had left for us was that they spent just as much time reamping and dialing in the guitar tones as actually mixing the entire song. So a lot of care went into getting these tones. Now, something that you can do if you kind of want to take your audio education up a notch, aside from just mixing the song as is, the song also has DIs, which is pretty cool. So you can go in and you can try reamping your own versions of these tones and see if you can beat them. And I think that's just really great practice, because again, it's not mixing, it's more of like a production decision. It's definitely pretty cool. And there's some pretty gnarly DIs, if I remember correctly. Let me find the one with the whammy baked in. That's so awesome. Okay, so let me find the DI. I think it's baked right in. Pretty awesome. So you have the ability to go in and try to actually reamp, reconstruct, and beat these guitar tones in your own mix, which I think is a lot of fun. And it's definitely worth doing, because it'll help you get better at mixing, help you get better at producing, help you get better at tone. And I think that's one of the things I see a lot of people struggling with when I see mix crits in the URM Rocktagon, is anytime a guitar tone isn't provided and people need to create a tone, they really, really, really struggle. So that's a skill worth taking time. Okay, let's take a look at some of the drums now. Again, these drums are very intricate. This drummer is incredible. A lot of accent cymbals, a lot of complicated patterns. We got kick drum, snare drum. Let's listen to those. There's also a lot of dynamics on this, so I think it'll be cool. There are MIDI tracks here where you can use your own triggers and stuff if you want, but if you want to keep some of the dynamic energy on this, these are really, really well recorded. I think you'll have a lot of fun mixing that. Okay, so on top of that, we've got toms. They're full bandwidth. I don't see anything cut out or anything like that. So if you want to strip silence them, you're going to have to. Let's hear the overheads. What's kind of cool is they chose to go audience perspective on this. You don't always see that. Sometimes you get the hi-hat on the left side, and they've chosen to put it from where you're watching the band and watching the drummer, as opposed to listening from behind the drummer's kit, which is cool because you get the floor tom on the left side. We got a hi-hat and a ride spot mic. Looks like they included some parallel mics. We got a parallel room. That sounds pretty explosive. We got another room, another parallel version of that. A mono. Some nice compression on that, and another mono. So you've got some really cool tones that you can use. And then definitely I see some spot mites here for the stacks, which I think is going to be very useful judging how intricate these parts are. Oh yeah, look at that. So it is definitely going to be a challenge to mix these drums because of how intricate they are and the level of options that you have. Like there's a lot of cool room sounds and things like that that you can use to create different vibes and ambiences at different parts of the song. And like I said, if you want, you are also provided the MIDI here. So you can come in and you can trigger up your sounds if you want to get more like consistency or something like that. Okay, so let's take a look at the bass tones real quick and see what we got under the hood. Okay, we have a DI. Mic'd with a Beta 56. Beta 52. Okay, then we've got this PR20. And an octave, I'm assuming it's an octava. Okay, so we have a cleaner bass tone in a different section of the song. And then when it gets a little bit heavier, I bring in some of the distortions to go with the glassy tone. And that's something I'm a huge fan of as a mixer. And if a producer hasn't put it in a song, usually my assistant and I will actually take the time to reamp the bass and put some of the stuff in. We like to have different bass tones in different parts of the song because it helps different parts feel differently and pop differently. Like obviously, you know, most people wouldn't want really nasty, grungy, clanking distortion during a verse and get for a cleaner tone. But, you know, on a heavier part with a heavier breakdown or whatever, you know, you can really dig in and bring out some of that extra aggression. So having multiple layers of bass tones, I think, is really powerful and cool. And then last but not least, we have some cool synth production here. A lot of synths, these synths are in the mid-range. Okay, I think that's definitely going to be something else that's going to be really challenging about this mix is when you have synths that are in the mid-range octave, right? Naturally, their frequencies are going to conflict more with the guitars and things like that. Now, that being said, in this mix, a lot of the guitars are super low. So that's why it would make sense to put them in the mid-range, the synths. Whereas like if you had a lot of guitar mid-range and say the guitars were an octave up in a more standard tuning, like, you know, E or even C standard or something like that, or, you know, drop B flat, whatever. If you put synths in the mid-range like this, you're really going to have a lot of conflicts. But again, there's no vocals to fight with and things like that. So I think that this is also kind of a cool challenge is trying to get these synths to really pop and cut through all the guitars and get all of the different sectional dynamics of this to sound massive individually, but also get everything working together as a whole in a comprehensive song. And one final note here, one of the coolest opportunities you have here on Nail the Mix is obviously mixing the song is incredible, but really being able to get inside the mind of the producer and the band and just seeing how they think, how they build a song, how they construct it. I think it's invaluable if you're a musician and you're into production, being able to understand and to study this stuff. For example, they've provided all of the synths here, and you can actually go in on the MIDI and see how they have composed this, and you can look at this, and you can break this down. You can analyze, you know, the chords, the keys, the type of ways they've arranged and stacked. And everything you need to know, all the clues for this song are here on this grid, all the arrangement, you can look at it, you can analyze it, you can break it down, and then get inspiration to use in your own productions, which is just super powerful and super exciting. So I'm very glad that they included all of the parts in here, and you can play around with the MIDI, or you could even try using your own synths and, you know, remake the song. You have the DIs, you can redo the tones if you want. So there you have it. That is Red Miso by Animals as Leaders. If you're not familiar with Nail the Mix, I'm going to take a second here now to break it down for you. So when you go to nailthemix.com and you sign up, there are two levels at Nail the Mix. There's a Nail the Mix level where you get to mix this song and you get to go through, and every month we have a different mixer with a different song. For example, last month we have Decapitated, Just a Cigarette mixed by David Castillo. Every month we have a different song, a different mixer, and it's really awesome. But we also have a couple other things. We have Mix Labs, which are bite size things for people that don't have a lot of time, but maybe want to pick up something in like 5 minutes. You can head over to the Mix Lab section. And, you know, if you want to learn about guitars or drums or vocals or post effects, you know, whatever, it's all right there. And the other thing you get is Portfolio Builder, which is really cool. It's included with your Nail the Mix subscription, where you can mix a ton of just cool bands, cool stuff, different genres, and use them in your own portfolio to demonstrate your own work or just, you know, practice. Not only that, but we also just added some mastering practice tracks and things like that. So that's pretty cool. That all comes with your subscription. Now, if you want to step it up and you want to get really, really serious about audio production, I recommend URM Enhance. It has the Fast Track library, which is over 60 plus super deep dive courses. So I nail the mix, we mix a song from start to finish. But in a Fast Track, for example, in the Fast Track library and in URM Enhanced, we might actually sit down and just talk about compression for like 3 or 4 hours, or do like a 6 hour EQ trainer or something like that. I mean, there's over 150 hours of content. It's the most thorough, deepest content you're going to find anywhere on the internet as far as we're concerned. So we highly recommend you upgrade to Enhance. It's nailthemix.com/upgrade. And you can upgrade for only $1 on your first month, which is super cool and really, really powerful. So not only do you get that, but we also have what's called Mix Rescue, where a pro will take your mix and they will break it down and remix it for you. And you can kind of see how a pro might look at your mix and essentially say, hey, you know, if you were to do this or break this down like this, et cetera, you can improve it. So we've got that. And then we also have one-on-ones where people can book sessions. You can sit down with our team and get feedback on your mixes or your career or whatever you're trying to do. So you get all of those amazing things, plus the most incredible, positive, excellent community on the entire internet and audio that's all positive. You're not going to find any trolling. You can ask any question, no matter how, you know, stupid you might think it is or whatever, and no one's going to come in and insult you. None of that stuff is tolerated. It's just a super positive place where people just come and everybody loves the community at URM, and we are very, very strict about it. And it's just all positive, and there's just always amazing things going on. We do live streams, Q&As, et cetera, that are in addition to the subscription that don't cost anything extra. So make sure you check all that stuff out. It's nailthemix.com. I hope you enjoy mixing this song by Animals as Leaders, and happy mixing, everybody.